Let's say we have a corpus consisting of the following two documents, each a single short sentence. 1. I was at the pool today. 2. The pool today was quite refreshing. To set up a numeric matrix representation of the corpus, we'll put one document on each row of the table, that is, a vector. The collection of unique terms in the corpus, also called the vocabulary, will be represented in the columns. Since we have 8 words in our corpus, we'll thus have 8 columns. If a particular term is not present in a document, we'll set its cell value to 0. If it is present, we'll set it to 1. This binary representation is sometimes called hot encoding. We could also use term frequencies instead. In any case, this way of organizing the contents of our corpus into a matrix space will be useful later to measure the relationships and similarities among documents. It's useful in that documents that are close to one another in the vector space are similar in content. In KNIME, we can create the sparse matrix from a collection of documents using the document vector node. To use the document vector node, we first need to make sure a bag of words creator node has been successfully executed upstream, since it's the source for the vocabulary of our corpus. If we also want to use a frequency measure to populate our document vectors instead of hot encoding, we will need a node upstream that calculates this as well, for example, the TF node. Let's use the IMDB dataset to create a document vector. Here, I have a meta node where I've applied the appropriate pre-processing steps. I've also split the dataset into training and testing sets using a partitioning node, followed by creation of a bag of words, as well as calculation of term frequencies on each branch. You can see here the current form of the data in the output port of the top branch. Now, let's take this data and input it to a document vector node. In its configuration dialog, I need to first choose my document column. The first option, Ignore Tags, will consider a particular word as the same term even if its tags are different. We'll leave this unchecked. The next option, Bit Vector, determines whether we use hot encoding, if it's checked, or a frequency measure, if it's unchecked. Here, we'll uncheck the box and select the appropriate TF column from the dropdown. The last option, As Collection Cell, controls the output of the document vector itself. Since we want to have a NIME column for each term in our vocabulary, we'll leave this unchecked too. Let's execute the node and look at the tabular results. You'll see that we have several hundred rows representing individual movie reviews, and several thousand columns for all the terms in our corpus. Most of the values in this sparse matrix are 0, but you see here and there TF values representing how often terms appear in individual documents. This is the mathematical representation of our dataset that we can use going forward. You'll also notice that this node has a gray square model output port that we may choose to use in some cases. Let's see how we might use it. In cases where you've split your data into testing and training sets, as we've just done, oftentimes the vocabulary of the two datasets will differ. We may want to make sure that only the vocabulary of the training set is used going forward. To do this, we can use the document vector applier node. This node takes as input the vocabulary model generated by a preceding document vector node, as well as our test input data processed with a bag of words creator. In its configuration dialog, we choose the appropriate document column, as well as whether we want to use the input model or not. If the Use Settings from Model box is unchecked, the Include-Exclude dialog becomes enabled, and we can then customize vocabulary on a word-by-word basis. The other options are similar to those we've seen already. After execution of the node, where words are present in the training set that don't exist in the test set, the frequency for those words will be set to 0. For the opposite case, where we have words in the test set that don't exist in the training set, those words will not appear as columns in our resulting matrix. To sum up, in this video we've learned about different nodes that can help us transform our text data from its usual form into a term document matrix using the document vector node. This transformation is essential for applying machine learning algorithms to our text data for common use cases like text classification or clustering.